Right now, I think I'm more confident, I feel more secure, but also afraid, because like you say, man, there's nothing for sure. Like, you ask, I mean, even in this country, something good is happening about this economic crisis, that nobody knows what's going to happen the next day. Because even people that had jobs that they thought that they would be forever and they would receive at the end the pension and everything, they are being fired. So I think that's a call for us, in the, like I'm saying, in spirituality. That this world is getting comfortable, like put all the beliefs in the material world, because we thought that that was the way. And because I'm from Latin America, I see the other side of the coin. I mean, I see like it's not perfect, but right now the whole world is in this same feeling of insecurity, of uncertainty. Uncertainty, I think that's the correct way to say. So I think that's good, because that is a call to understand that not everything is about material means. So if, I mean, there's another part of us, like the spiritual part, that I really believe in. So that's why I think.
But do you have a family?
Yes, I have a wife, and we're expecting a baby.
Oh,
wow. Congratulations!
Yes, thank you. So I have to say that's why my faith is being stronger, because everything's like aligned. I don't have to be worrying. Things are happening very smooth. You know, and like you say, smooth is without struggle, without having to worry too much. Just that be sure that you are doing. I mean, there's one word in English that is new for me, that was new for me, but it applies, is procrastination. Have you ever heard about that word, procrastination?
Yeah.
Okay, so I think that's like an obstacle for everybody, but because you have a call, you have a talent, but sometimes because you don't believe in yourself, or you think that you will not make it in that way, you don't do it. Or just because you're lazy and you prefer to watch TV, you don't do it. But when the time passes by, you will see like procrastination will be a bigger and a bigger obstacle. So I think overcoming that is really important. To know that you can make things that you believe, but you have to make it. And nobody will make it for you. You have to really work the things that you believe in. You have to do the work. And you will, I mean, not everything will be perfect. You will hit walls. People will say no. But I mean, there's nothing to lose. That's why I'm learning. I've been a lot of times listening a lot of no's from companies, from people, opportunities. But still, when there's a no, there are other yes. There's a yes. What I'm saying is, we can't stop just because someone is saying to us no, or because someone doesn't like what we do.
This is what I was telling them, that you are the future. People, many of these people here will not have a job for 20 years.
Mm-hmm.
Their company will die and they will be unemployed. What will they do?
I've seen this because I'm working with my own company, and I can see these things, especially in the ad industry. In the advertising industry, it's totally like that. Because I mean, I can see that, like, if I am the owner, I prefer to just hire satellite or just, how do you call this?
Satellite is a good name. Yeah. Temporary workers.
Yeah, temporary workers.
Freelance contractors.
Right. Why? Because if you hire someone, you have to be in charge of their health, you have to be in charge of their pension, you have to be in charge of many, many things. But if you hire a contractor, you don't have to even have a place in your office. You just have to give them through the with the internet, another incredible tool. You don't have to send all the information through emails or to any way, and you don't have to even be present in the office. You can be living in other countries, which is, I think that's an advantage. For me, that's an advantage. I can do any kind of project, and I have done projects from other cities to other cities. So it's not to be scared, it's to take advantage of that. And I like it, because right now, for instance, I am working in a project. This project is very interesting. I am working in the in a project called Global Justice for Guatemala. Guatemala.
You want to put the name up?
Yeah. I will put the name in.
Yeah, you can write there.
Okay.
Oh, you're an expert now. Yeah,
Okay.
So this is in Spanish. Justicia global. We are in the United States. This is the thing, we are in the United States. But the name of the project is in Spanish because it's going to reach Spanish speakers from the people from Guatemala, migrants that are coming to this country to work, but some of them are illegal, or most of them. And the reality is deeper than that. The situation is these people, they have rights, but they don't know they have rights. So I'm working for this project, which involves the Guatemalan government and involves law offices that are working with the government offices. And the idea is to reach these people and to let them know that they have rights. So what I'm doing for them is I'm creating I already created the logo of this project, and I didn't bring my laptop. I leave it in the car. I thought I'd bring, but I have the logo of the project. I am doing all the communication, posters, banners. They have wallet cards. Something called wallet card is when the police stop them, they can show and say, look, I have some rights. Because usually there's one case that one of the cases that shows why this project is happening. It's a woman that came to this country because she was living in Guatemala. She's from Guatemala, and the conditions of poverty and violence push her to leave her country and to come here in the United States. But they will never get any visa or any kind of paperwork like you have. They have to come through the border, through Mexico. And believe me, they don't want to come here. They just have to come here. They are looking for a better future because they live in so much poverty and despair, I mean, how do you say, desperation and violence. They are finding a solution. So they come here, and this woman came. She lived here, she had two kids, and by the time that she had the kids as babies, she was caught by the police. She was arrested, and she claimed for help. She told them, I have babies. They just took the address of her house, took her, deported her to Guatemala, and it was 5 years ago. So what happened is they sent her to Guatemala, and the babies stayed here, and the government said, because the mother leaves the kids, now we are going to put these kids on adoption. So they gave these kids to another family. And now the people that I'm working for, they fight. And finally, 5 years later, they are going to reunite this family. They are going to give the kids back to her mother. But of course, these kids are already 5 years old. So they need to work with psychologists because they really don't know her mother. So this is a very tough situation. I mean, I think I understand about illegality, that you cannot go to any country without papers. But this situation, when you see the poverty that is happening in Guatemala, all these things that push people to fight for a better future, to even to survive, to not be killed. Sometimes they have to move, but then they face all these problems. So I think that's another way that art is not only graphic design to make a profit, to make an animation for sharks, to sell TVs, like what I do, but also that you can create something that will help. Actually, that will reach 1.6 million people in this country. It's a lot of people. So, I don't know. I mean, every person has a call. It's just to know what it is, and we are not the same. So you have the arts here. I don't know what are your professions, but I believe you have a call. Sometimes maybe you are very young and you don't know what to do. So maybe you just have to be relaxed, not to worry, but open your ears, your eyes, and what moves you is, and what drives you, you know what the word drives you, what moves you in your heart, that's the call. Because the rest, I mean, some people say, but I don't have talent. I mean, you can draw, you can do these drawings, but I don't know even how to draw. And I can tell you that one part of what you do is talent, but without work, that's nothing.